In this video, we're given a velocity function for a particle. So this describes the velocity in meters per second as a function of time given in seconds. And we're asked to use this to compute the displacement of the particle on a time interval 1 to 2. And so it's critical here to remember that the position function is the antiderivative of the velocity function. And this means if we integrate a velocity function, we would do that by guessing the antiderivative, well, that's the position as a function of time, and then evaluating across the limits of integration. And that's precisely what displacement is. That's the final position minus the initial position. All right, so to get a displacement, you just take the definite integral of the velocity function. And we'll put this into practice on the time interval 1 to 2 with the specific velocity function, negative 0.6 t squared plus 2.5 dt. And we guess the antiderivative here. The negative 0.6 is a spectator, and then t squared integrates to t cubed over 3. And the 2.5 integrates to 2.5 t. That's the thing I differentiate to get 2.5. And then I evaluate from 1 to 2. We can clean things up a little bit in the first term by canceling a factor of 3, which would change that to a 0.2, negative 0.2 t cubed in the first term. Then I sub in the upper limit, and I get negative 0.2 times 2 cubed plus 2.5 times 2 minus negative 0.2 times 1 cubed plus the 2.5 times 1. So in this first term, I have a 0.2 times 2 cubed, which is 0.2 times 8. That gives me 1.6, and there's a minus sign in front of it still, so 1.6. Second term, 2.5 times 2 is 5. Third term is going to be positive because of distributing that minus sign, and I get a positive 0.2 for that. And the fourth term is going to be negative from distributing that minus sign, and I get just a 2.5 for that negative. And when I run the numbers on this, I get a final displacement of 1.1, and the units on that are meters, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.